Welcome back to SnowRunner, guys, and today we are going to be having a look at JonJon Hot Rod's console-friendly Duramax swapped Chevy square body dually. Now, this truck has a ton of different add-ons, a ton of different possible setups, and a ton of different things that it can be used for. Now, there's basically, and you can see actually right there through the grill how massive the freaking intercooler is, but there are all sorts of setups ranging from vanilla gameplay style up to, like, you know, absolutely barrel through the terrain and go nuts type style. But this is sort of your default configuration. And I've got to say, this, for a default configuration, is absolutely incredible. Now, we've come to the first map in the new main region to take a look at this thing, and I'm going to go into interior view and also show you guys around what this thing looks like on the inside. Now, for those of you that like to play this game on the interior view, I think you'll really enjoy and appreciate what this truck has going on in the interior, because you have fully modeled, like, door panels, seats, seat belts, you know, like, freaking window winders, a dash. Like, there's all sorts of great stuff in this truck, both for people that like playing on the interior view and people that like playing on the exterior view. But now we're gonna go ahead and go back into the garage, and we're gonna do a custom setup on this thing before taking it for a drive. Now, obviously, this can be used for scouting, support, hauling. It can be used for just about whatever you want to use it for, but personally, I'm just super excited to see that we have a square body quad cab dually that also has been updated with a modern diesel engine. I think that's, like, the coolest freaking thing. So we have stockish diesel spec. This is a slightly detuned 6.6 V8 diesel for a stockish style of driving. Grocery getter is 910 foot-pounds of torque, and it requires less throttle control than the Trail Runner spec tune. There's also the Tow and Haul HD spec, which is 1400 foot-pounds of torque, and there's the Trail Runner spec, which spits out just enough horsepower and torque to have fun while still being completely manageable on the trails. And then there is the vanilla diesel spec, which is based on the SnowRunner Scout F750 tune. So if you want this thing to be based around a genuinely vanilla tune setup, that is what you're going to use. Now, I am going to use the Tow and Haul HD spec. And then gearbox wise, we have heavy tow and haul 4-speed, we have low and slow experimental crawler, we have stockish spec 6-speed, we have tow and haul 10-speed, Trail Runner 6-speed, and vanilla 6-speed, which the vanilla 6-speed is once again based on the F750. So we're gonna go with the tow and haul 10-speed, and I'm thinking, oh dude, so we actually have the option to run the King of the Hammers setup. That's sick. But before we get into that, we also have a show truck style slammed setup. And I know that there's going to be some people out there that are going to be like, what's the point of that? Why is that in this game? This is an off-road game, not a slammed truck game. Although, if you wanted to have multiple variants of this truck, or let's say, for example, you wanted to do like a show truck roleplay, that is available there for you if you want to go that route. Now, there is stockish lifted, stockish max, which is a no damage lifted version of the previous two lifted suspensions. Then you have lifted max tow and haul, which is gigantic. Then you have lifted tow and haul. You have stockish tow and haul, max crawler, and trail runner. So there's a ton of different potential specs. Now, let's see. We're going to go with the lifted max just to see how that looks. And then tires-wise, you're going to start on a 34. There's also the 35-inch slammed spec, which basically bumps up the wheel size and lowers the amount of sidewall you have to make it look a little bit more like a show truck. And let's see. True to specs, dirt 8 out of 10, mud 9 out of 10, pavement 10 out of 10. Bruh, that's hilarious. So we have the Trepidor Runner, once again, based on the Trepidor Mud Runner terrain. These are a lot of the console-friendly tires that are from JonJon Hot Rod's other mods. These look, for example, like a BFG KM3. We got the X-Runner terrain, we've got the MTR, we've got the Trepidor Runner, again, in a 41. We've got some 40s, then it goes up to a 45, which looks super beefy on this thing. And we haven't even gotten into the wheel selections yet. So let's see, stock all-terrain for mud and ice. Then we have the Swamp Runner, which this gets into all of the mud-ready tires and the bog-ready tires. Holy crap, you can have dually swampers in 45-inch. That is amazing. That is absolutely freaking amazing. This is the SnowRunner terrain, snow and ice, and those look really, really good as well. Now, I think I'm going back and forth here. I really am going back and forth here because I think what I'm going to do and what I'm going to go with is I'm going to probably go back up And I really like these. I like those a lot. But I also, yeah, the 45 Mudrunner terrains. I gotta add the BFGs, man. They look so good. You can switch to a vanilla winch if you would prefer that playstyle, but I'm gonna stay with the Trail Runner style winch. And then we've got the invisible roll cage snorkel, so it's essentially always on. We have the invisible additional chassis weight for use with the tow spec suspensions. Then we also have a gooseneck hitch for the stock bed and a shorty hitch and a gooseneck hitch for the flatbed, which we haven't installed just yet, but I'll show you guys what that looks like. And then we also have the shorty hitch for the stock bed. And then let's see, stock bed pintail hitch. Let's do the shorty hitch for that. And then let me go back. Never mind. Oh, I see. So that's all the tow and haul stuff. Then you get to the front clips. So you can actually have 70s, 80s, or 89 to 91, which that style of front end is not a front end that we see on a lot of rigs in SnowRunner. So it's really cool to see it. But either way, if you like the round headlight style, the square headlight style, whatever style you prefer, you can select that right there. Now, also, you can remove it and get a look at the built Duramax in all its glory right there. Look at those turbos. They look absolutely incredible. And the freaking size of the intercooler, that's just like absolutely next level. Now, you can go for a flatbed design if you so choose. There's also flatbed plywood that you can put on. And that right there, I mean, if you want to talk about really cool roleplay opportunities, that's some really cool roleplay opportunities right there. You can also put stakes on the side. You can do, stakeside tailgate. That's so cool. Pickup bed plywood. Bro, that's so cool. Hang on. Where's the dually bed? There it is. And then the pickup bed plywood, you can throw that right there in the back. Oh, I love that. That is so freaking cool. Bro, I love that so much. I absolutely love that. Now, we are going to have to do a... We're going to have to reinstall that hitch. And where is the... Uh-oh. Oh, God. We lost our bumper. Yep, I don't know what happened to the bumper, but... Oh, there it is. Okay, stock rear bumper. Now, can we do a... Ooh, classic bull bar, desert runner bumper. Ooh, I like that a lot. Let me do the rear tube bumper and the rear rock sliders. And then in the front, we will do a pre-runner style bumper. And then let's see. The roll cage, is that just going to go inside? I think I'm good on roll cages right now. I mean, the roll cage, I don't think we necessarily need the roll cage at the moment, but oh, that looks so good though. Like a full-on overland rack. Bro, what? This has like a generator, toolboxes, there's planks up there. That's so cool. I don't know if I'm going to put that on this particular build, but it's definitely one that I'm going to be using in the future. Bro, you've got like American Force dualies, Arsenal Custom dualies, Forged dualies, Standard dualies. Wow. There's so much that you can put on this thing. So freaking much. I'm gonna stick with those arsenals, but like, man, they look so good. You can also go with more of a weathered paint look or a glossy polished paint look. And again, that is all up to you in terms of how you wanna set this thing up. But as with most of JonJon Hot Rod's mods, there are a lot, and I mean a lot of choices. Man, he really upped his game too with the way these weathered paint jobs look. They look amazing. You can also go for a single tone if that's more of your style or more of your personal taste. And then down here at the bottom, you could actually go with a kind of a single tone that also has that weathered paint look. So at the end of the day, there is quite literally an endless amount of options. Like, we're talking absolutely freaking endless. I love that dark red. That dark red is amazing. And it's not the red that I normally run, but boy, does it look freaking amazing. Now, let me go ahead and restart that afternoon day and night cycle right there. And let's go ahead and fire this thing up and take it for a drive. Oh, dude. The way that sounds, though. I'm just gonna be quiet for a second to let you guys hear what this sounds like. It really does sound so good. I absolutely love the way this thing sounds. And look at the lighting. Even the lights on the fenders in the rear work. Oh my, dude. This thing is so wild. It's so incredibly freaking wild. You can also throw the long log gooseneck in there. Really, any of Red's goosenecks are gonna work with this thing, but man, I know I don't have the tow setup on it right now, but bro, doesn't that look like so perfect? God, that setup looks so right. Now, if I was going to do a long haul with this thing, I would absolutely switch over to the towing-focused suspensions. But man, yo, look at that new Scout trailer, though. That new Scout trailer is sick. I love that thing. I don't know what happened to my hitch. I guess I didn't install it properly, but look at that. That new Scout trailer is awesome. It's not even, like, squatting the back end of this truck, like, at all, either. That's pretty gnarly. But let's go ahead and take this thing out into the wilderness in Maine. And why did I go between these freaking... Oh, God. There we go. Why did I go in between the concrete barricades? I meant to go around them or, like, just on the road itself. And I did everything but that. So let's put it into this mud real quick and see how it does. Let's go. That's insane. The fact that it's got that much grip, what? Okay. I mean, I know we went for a moderately powerful setup. I didn't realize we went for a setup that was this powerful or this grippy. Let's see what you do in the mud. Good grief. This thing is so fast. Okay, let me put it into low now because I think we've moderately sunk the thing. Easy does it. Come on. Here we go. It's looking for it. It really is trying to find its footing right now. But I think one of the biggest things that... Wait a minute. Okay, I realized that the diff lock is always on, but I didn't have all-wheel drive on. So what's even crazier about that is the fact that on the way here, we did all of that just in rear-wheel drive. Holy smokes. Now that we're in all-wheel drive, I really don't see anything stopping it. Wow, this has Diesel Addict's name written all over it. It's literally like it was built for him. And, like, I don't necessarily think it was, but, man, if he had said, oh, yeah, this thing was built for me, I would have probably believed him because, man, it literally suits his playstyle that well. Now, if you're not aware, Diesel Addict is actually a good friend of mine that I play SnowRunner with a lot on the streams. I also play Horizon 5 with him on the streams, and this truck just absolutely embodies his entire playstyle. Let's make a run across this flooded, kind of swampy area and see how we get on through here. Now, ooh, okay, so it's a little iffy going against the current like that, but that's kind of, like, understandable. I feel like you would have to expect that, especially when you're going against current like this. This is a gnarly river current. This area of the main region actually kind of reminds me of the flood map back in MudRunner. Come on. Oop. Sketchy. But you know, I mean, if we need to get through there, we can get through there with the winch just fine. Now, I do want to kind of throw this thing at some rocks and see how it does when we try to actually climb some rocks with it. And there aren't necessarily too many. There's a couple of rocks over there, but where we're headed, we're going to be able to find a good amount more. Now, I know we're on a towing and hauling suspension, so we're not obviously going to be able to see all the flex, but what I do want to see is I want to see kind of the grip potential that we're talking about in terms of these tires. Now, this might be a doable... You know what? Yeah, forget it. We're going to climb this wall. Let's go. It's got a well-balanced center of gravity, actually, because if it didn't have a well-balanced center of gravity, it would have already flipped over. All right, we're on those rocks there. I just need to get my front tires up. Come on, there you go. Oh, geez. All right, I'm a little bit high-centered. Let me see if I can once again save this. There we go. Oh, bruh. Oh, my God. And that was with the towing suspension. This thing is gnarly. Like, the fact that it just walked right up that with the towing suspension speaks volumes about how crazy it's going to be when we throw the crawler suspension on this thing and take on some trails. But I definitely recommend that you guys get your hands on this truck as soon as you can. It's an absolute beast and definitely worth being in all of your garages. And if you enjoyed the video, let me know your thoughts and opinions on it in the comments below. Hit that like button if you enjoyed, subscribe if you're new, and I will see you guys next time. Talk to y'all later.